This is Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this problem about the initial phase angle of an undamped horizontal elastic pendulum, we are going to explain the method for the determination of the initial phase angle phi. Determine the initial phase angle in 5 different cases.
How to get the value or the values of phi in each of the following cases, knowing that phi belongs to the interval 0 to pi radians. First case, if cosine phi is equal to alpha, then the first value of phi can be given directly using the calculator, and that by pressing shift cosine alpha, so the calculator gives you the first value of phi, which is equal to phi 1. But the second value of phi cannot be given using the calculator, but this value is equal to minus the first value. So phi 1 and minus phi 1 are the values of phi in this case. Now, if sine phi is equal to alpha, similarly, the first value of phi can be given directly by pressing shift sine alpha on the calculator, so it gives phi 1, which is the first value of phi. But in this case, the second value of phi is given by pi minus the first value. Now, if tangent phi is equal to alpha, so the first value of phi is given by pressing shift tangent alpha on the calculator, so it gives you the first value of phi, which is equal to phi 1. But the second value of phi is equal to pi plus phi 1. Let's take an example on each of these three cases. If cosine phi is equal to 0.5, then the first value of phi can be written by pressing shift cosine 0.5 on the calculator, so it gives you the first value, which is equal to pi over 3 radians. But the second value of phi is equal to the first to minus the first value of phi, so it is equal to minus pi over 3 radians. So cosine pi over 3 or cosine minus pi over 3 radians is equal to 0.5. Now, if sine phi is equal to 0.5, then the first value of phi is given by pressing shift sine 0.5 on the calculator, so it gives you the first value, which is equal to pi over 6 radians. And the second value of phi is equal to pi minus the first value, which is pi minus pi over 6, and it is equal to 5 pi over 6 radians. Finally, if tangent phi is equal to 0.5, then the first value of phi is equal shift tangent 0.5, which is given by the calculator, and it is equal to 0.46 radians. And the second value of phi is given by phi 1 plus pi, or 0.46 plus pi, which is equal to 3.6 radians.
Now, sometimes when you calculate the two values of phi, they are equal. So actually, you have only one value for phi. Let me give you some examples. If cosine phi is equal to 1, using the calculator gives you shift cosine 1 is equal to 0. According to the previous slide, the second value is minus 0, but in standard mathematics, negative 0 is equivalent to positive 0 because the 0 is unsigned. So actually, we have one value. Another example, if cosine phi is equal to minus 1, using the calculator gives you shift cosine minus 1 is equal to pi radians. Look at the circle. According to the chosen positive sense, which is the counterclockwise sense here, this is pi. This is the angle pi radians. Now, in the negative sense, this is the angle minus pi radians. As you see, pi radians and minus pi radians are in the same position. So pi radians is equivalent to minus pi radians. Therefore, we have only one value for phi. The third example, if sine phi is equal to 1, Then, using the calculator, pi is equal to shift sign 1, which is equal to pi over 2 radians. According to the previous slide, you get the second value by subtracting pi over 2 from pi. So the second value is pi minus pi over 2, which is equal to pi over 2. So we have one value. The final example, f sine pi is equal to minus 1. Then the calculator will give you minus pi over 2 radians. Okay, now the second value, pi minus minus pi over 2 radians, which gives you 3 pi over 2 radians. So as you see, 3 pi over 2 radians and minus pi over 2 radians are on the same position on the circle. This one is with the chosen positive sense and this one is in the negative sense, so they are equivalent, and actually we have only one value for pi in this case also.
Now let's solve an application to determine the value of the initial phase angle phi. Consider the time equation of a simple harmonic motion. So x is equal to xm sine omega 0 t plus phi, and v equal x prime equal xm omega 0 cosine omega 0 t plus phi. Determine the value of phi in each case of the following initial conditions. First, initial conditions. At t 0 equal to 0, x is equal to xm. So using the time equation, and now substitute x equal xm for t equal to 0. We get this new relation. Xm is equal xm sine phi. Then sine phi is equal to 1. As you know, when sine phi is equal to 1, we have only one value of phi, which is equal to pi over 2 radians.
Now let's move to the second case. At t0 is equal to 0, x0 is equal to 0, and the oscillator moves in the positive direction, which means that v0 is positive. So we have x is equal to xm sine omega 0 t plus pi. Now, replace x by 0 and t by 0. This is going to be 0 is equal to xm sine phi. But xm is different from 0. So sine phi is equal to 0. So the first value of phi is 0. And the second value is pi minus 0, which is equal to pi. So we must choose one of these two values. Now we go to v. V is equal to xm omega 0 cosine omega 0 t plus phi, because you know when you want to calculate the value of phi, you calculate it from the initial conditions of x0 and v0. So now we will replace v by v0 and t by 0. This is going to be v0 is equal to xm omega 0 cosine phi. But xm omega 0 is positive and v0 is positive. So cosine phi is positive. Now, which one of the values 0 and pi radians has a positive cosine? You know that cosine pi is equal to minus 1, which is negative, but the cosine of our angle is positive, so we will choose 0. So pi is equal to 0.
Question number 3, or the third initial conditions. At t0 equal 0, x is equal to 0 and the oscillator moves in the negative direction. The oscillator moves in the negative direction, that means v of 0 is negative. Using the time equation, and then substitute x for t equal 0. Therefore, 0 is equal to xm sine phi. But xm cannot be 0. Therefore, sine phi must be 0. Then, the first value of phi is given by shift sine 0, which is equal to 0. And the second value of phi is equal to pi minus 0, which is equal to pi radians. Now we have two values, 0 or pi. One of these values is the value of phi. To know which one is the correct, we have to use the initial condition of V0. So, we have V equal xm omega 0 cosine omega 0 t plus phi. So, substitute for t or substitute V for t equals 0, we get V of 0 equal xm omega 0 cosine phi. But V of 0 is negative, xm is positive. Omega 0, which is equal to the square root of k over m, is also positive. So xm times omega 0 is positive. Therefore, cosine phi must be negative. But cosine 0 is equal to 1, which is positive. So 0 cannot satisfy this condition. Therefore, the value of phi is equal to pi radians.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now let's move to the fourth part, or the fourth case. At 0 equal to 0, x0 is equal to minus 4 centimeters, and v0 is equal to 0.48 meters per second. And in this part, I will give you the natural angular frequency because you need it. It is 2 radians per second. So we have x is equal to xm sine omega 0 t plus phi. So this is given from the beginning of the question. Now replace x by x0 and t by 0. So we will have minus 0.04 meters, because you divide 4 centimeters by 100 to become 0.04 meters. T is 0, so you will get xm sine phi. Now we have two unknowns. Xm is unknown and sine phi is unknown. So this is equation 1. Now let's move to the expression of V. Replace V by V0 and T by 0. This is going to be 0.14 is equal to omega 0 xm cosine phi. This is equation 2. Now, remember, we want to determine the value of phi, and you have two equations. And the first one you have sine phi, and in the second one you have cosine phi. So if we divide equation 1 by equation 2, we will get minus 0.04, the left side of equation 1, over 0.14, the left side of equation 2, over the right side xm sine phi of equation 1, over the right side omega 0 xm cosine phi of equation 2. Now, sine phi over cosine phi is equal to tangent phi, and omega 0 is equal to 2 radians per second. So this is going to be, as you see, minus 0.04 over 0.14 is equal to tangent phi over 2. So tangent phi is equal to minus 0.571. Now, use the calculator. Shift tangent minus 0.571 gives you phi is equal to minus pi over 6 radians. As we explained in the first slide, the second value of phi is obtained by adding pi to the first value. So the second value is minus pi over 6 plus pi, which is 5 pi over 6 radians. Now we must choose one of these two values. Now we have the two values of phi and equation 1 and tangent phi. Now, let's start with the tangent. This tangent is negative. Now, move to equation 1. Xm is positive, and here we have a minus sign. So, sine phi is negative. Now, we will choose the angle that satisfies these two conditions. Let's start with the angle 5 pi over 6 radians. Use your calculator. Sine this angle is positive, so it does not satisfy the second condition, so we will not choose this angle. But we will choose the first angle, minus pi over 6 radians or minus 30 degrees because this angle satisfies the two conditions. Its tangent is negative and also its sine is negative. Now, note, if you want to calculate xm, so you can use equation 1 where xm is equal to minus 0.04 over sine phi, which is minus pi over 6 radians, and the answer is 0.08 meters or 8 centimeters.
Consider the time equations in a simple harmonic motion. X equal a sine omega 0 t plus phi and v equal x prime equal omega 0 a cosine omega 0 t plus phi. Omega 0 is equal to 2 radians per second and a is a negative constant. Now, the question is determine the values of a and the initial phase angle phi if at t0 equal to 0, x of 0 equal minus 4 centimeters and v of 0 is equal to 0.2 meters per second. So, substitute x for t equals 0 in this equation, we get x of 0, which is minus 0.04 meter, equal a sine phi. Then, sine phi equal minus 0.04 over a, which is equation 1. Similarly, substitute v for t equal 0 in this equation, we get v of 0, which is 0.2 meters per second, equal omega 0 a cosine phi. Then cosine phi equals 0.2 over omega 0 a, which is equation 2. As you know, sine squared phi plus cosine squared phi is equal to 1. So we can write minus 0.04 over a squared plus 0.2 over omega 0 a squared is equal to 1. Now, multiplying both sides by a squared, we get minus 0.04 squared plus 0.2 over omega 0, which is equal to 2 squared equal a squared. Since a has a negative value, so a equal minus the square root of 16 times 10 to the power minus 4, which is the square of minus 0.04 plus 2 times 10 to the power minus 2, which is the square of 0.1. So we get the value of A, which is equal to minus 0.196 meters. Now, equation 2 says that cosine phi equals 0.2 over omega 0 A. And A, already calculated in the previous slide, which is equal to minus 0.196. Then substitute omega 0 and a in equation 2. So cosine phi equals 0.2 over 2 times minus 0.196. Then cosine phi equals minus 0.51. So phi is equal to 2.1 radians or equal shift cosine minus 0.51. And the second value of phi is equal to minus 2.1 radians. As you know, one of these values is the real value of phi. Using equation 1, sine phi equal minus 0.04 over a, but a is negative, then minus 0.04 over a has a positive value, so sine phi must be positive. But sine minus 2.1 radians is a negative, so the value of phi or minus 2.1 radians is not an acceptable value of phi. Therefore, the acceptable value of phi is equal to 2.1 radians. Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.